The voices calling for a bullet train are growing louder as the state faces a deadline this week.
In Tampa, dozens gathered to protest Governor Rick Scott's decision to reject federal money for high-speed rail. Scott has until Friday to find additional funding or government money will go to other states.
Today, the governor was in Central Florida delivering the strongest language yet opposing the bullet train. WESH 2's Greg Fox live in the studio right now. And Greg, what options are left?
Well, the best option right now appears to be a partnership that would involve cities and counties along the route, with Orlando being one of the two major players. But Scott is still insisting that a private company, not government, assume 100% of the financial risk in this project or no deal.
Governor Scott celebrated the opening of Embraer's new $41 million jet center in Melbourne. He called that an example of industry creating jobs and used that to further cast doubt on the construction of high-speed rail between Orlando and Tampa.
I am not going to spend $1 taxpayer money on the high-speed rail project.
The governor described as hypotheticals the last-minute scrambling going on to somehow persuade him to approve the spending of $2.4 billion federal dollars in Florida on the 84-mile line.
I'm worried about the cost overruns, I'm worried about the operating costs, and I'm worried about if it ever gets shut down, the state is on the hook, the taxpayers. Each of you is on the hook for $2.4 billion.
I don't see it that way.
Democrat U.S. Senator Bill Nelson and attorneys with the Department of Transportation will be meeting with Scott attorneys to try and broker a deal that would allow a private company to receive the federal money to build the bullet train and assume full financial risk.
The project would be a privatized project in the private sector to build the high-speed rail, to operate it, and to maintain it.
The cities of Orlando and Tampa are also considering a partnership that could create a new public entity that could steward the project, but that, too, would require the governor's approval.
Governor Scott also asked if he's made a final decision yet to release millions of dollars to continue the SunRail commuter train project. His two-word reply, absolutely not. Jim, Martha.